Okay, let us solve some problems on plugging. So the first problem is a 40 kilowatts 440 volts DC shunt motor is braked by plugging, and you have to calculate the value of the resistance that must be placed in series with the armature circuit to limit the initial braking current to 150 amperes. Okay, so you have to calculate the value of the resistance that must be placed in series to the armature to limit the initial braking current to 150 amperes. And you must also calculate the braking torque, and you must calculate the torque when motor speed falls to 360 RPM. Okay. Some data is given, that is armature resistance is 0.1 ohms, full load current is 100 amperes, full load speed is 600 RPM. Okay, so this is the given problem. We have to determine the value of the resistance that must be placed in series to the armature to limit the initial braking current. We have to determine the braking torque as well as the torque when motor speed falls to 360 RPM. Okay, note it down. As soon as you complete, inform me. Okay, power has been discontinued. Wait, I'll switch the user.
All of you wait. Okay, people, note down the problem. Meanwhile, I will switch the user.
Okay, so this is the given problem. Let us solve it. So let us initially determine the full load back EMF induced in the motor. Okay, So you already know the formula, EB is equal to V minus IRA. Okay, so for clarification, I have written EBFL is equal to V minus IAFL RA. So what is V? V is the voltage, terminal voltage or the supply voltage, I can say. So what is the value of V in the problem? You have already written, isn't it? Okay, so it is 440 volts. Okay, minus IAFL, that is the full load current. Full load current is 100 amperes. Armature resistance is given, that is 0.1 ohms. Okay, so 440 minus 100 into 0.1, you will get 430 volts. Okay, so the voltage across the armature at the starting of the braking. Okay, so just for giving some notation, I have written VST. Okay, so because it is at the starting of braking, that's why. Okay, so for clarity, I might have written. Okay, so. So it is the at the starting of braking, so just for clarity, VSTB, okay, is equal to what? V plus V is the terminal or supply voltage plus the full load back EMF. Okay, terminal voltage or supply voltage is given, that is 440 volts plus full load back EMF. Just now we have calculated, that is 430 volts. So 440 plus 430, you just add it, you will get 870 volts. Okay, now, so first of all, we have to calculate the value of the resistance that must be placed in series with the armature circuit to limit the initial braking current to 150 amperes. Okay, so first of all, let us determine that. So let us give some notation. RT is the armature resistance. Okay, RT is the armature resistance which is placed in series to the armature to limit the current to 150 amperes. So VT is equal, RT is equal to VST. VSTB by IB. IB is the braking current. Okay, so braking current means initial braking current, that is 150 amperes. So VSTB, you already know, just now we have calculated, it is a voltage across the armature at the starting of the brake. So VB, VSTB is nothing but 870 by 150. You just complete this slide, I will change it. As soon as you complete, type C. I'm going to check your notes while taking attendance, okay? As soon as you complete, inform me. Did you complete? Okay then. So this is RT is equal to what? 870 by 150. So 870 by 150, you will get 5.8 ohms. So RT is the resistance that is to be connected in series to the armature circuit to limit the initial braking current to 150 amperes. That is 5.8 ohms that you will get. Okay. So the value of the resistance that must be placed in series to the armature circuit to limit the initial braking current to 150 ohms. Okay. So till now, what we have determined is the total armature resistance that is required. Okay, this is the total armature resistance. I forgot to tell you. Okay, but this is the resistance R value, which is to be calculated by subtracting the armature resistance from this total
resistance. Okay, so if you subtract this RT, you will get 5.8 minus 0.1 is 5.7 ohms. Okay, so RT is the total resistance. Okay, so the resistance that must be placed in series is the total resistance that is to be connected in series minus the armature resistance. Okay, so now the we know for a shunt motor the braking torque is proportional to the flux and the armature current. Okay, so since in a shunt motor flux is constant, the braking torque will be proportional to the armature current. Okay, so torque is proportional to armature current. Therefore, what you can write is initial braking torque by a full load torque will be equal to initial braking current by full load current. Why? Because torque is braking torque is directly proportional to the armature current. Therefore, you can write initial braking torque by full load torque is equal to initial braking current by full load current. Okay, you complete this slide and inform me. Okay, RT is the total resistance that is to be connected in series to the armature circuit. Okay, if you subtract this total resistance with the armature resistance, you will get the resistance required to limit the armature means initial braking current in the armature circuit. Okay, but the total resistance required is RT. Did you complete? Okay. So since torque is proportional to the armature current, you can write this formula, that is initial braking torque by full load torque is equal to initial braking current by full load current. Okay. Now full load current formula, you might be already familiar with it. So full load torque formula is P by 2 pi into N by 60. Okay, P is already given in your problem, that is 40 kilowatts. Okay, so 40 into 10 to the 3 I have written, and the speed is also already given in the problem. Okay, full load speed is 600. So full load speed is 600. Okay. So 40 into 10 power 3 by 2 pi into 600 by 60. Okay, you just solve it, you will get 636.6 newton meter, the full load torque. Okay, now you know the full load torque. Okay, you can determine the initial braking torque. So initial braking torque is equal to full load torque. Okay, initial braking torque is full load torque into initial braking current by full load current. Okay, so full load torque is TFL into initial braking current, let us assume it as IB. Full load current is IAFL. Okay, just for clarification, I have written these notations. Okay, so full load torque is what? 636.6 into IB is what? 150, it is given in the problem. IA is also given, IAFL 100. Okay, so 636.6 into 150 by 100, you will get 955 newton meter. As soon as you complete, inform me. So this formula I have derived it based on this expression, okay? And this expression I have written based on torque proportional to the armature current. Did you complete? Okay then. Okay, so we have determined the initial braking torque and okay, so let us determine the decrease in the back EMF. Okay, let us determine the back EMF at 360. Let us determine the back EMF at 360 RPM. So formula is back EMF at full load into 360 by N. This 360 is the speed that is mentioned in the problem. Okay, very good. Okay, so now the decrease in the back EMF will be directly proportional to the decrease in the motor speed. Therefore, back EMF at 360 RPM is equal to EB full load into 360 by N. So EB full load we have already calculated earlier, that is 430 into 360 by N is what full load speed is given, that is 600. So 430 into 360 by 600 is, you will get 258 volts, okay, EB. Similarly, armature current at 360 RPM is the supply voltage plus EB at 360 RPM by the total resistance required to connect in series to the armature to limit the initial current to 150 amperes is 5.8, isn't it? We have calculated it. So V is 440 plus EB at 360 is what? 258 plus 5.8. You will get 120 amperes. Okay. So IA at 360 amperes we have determined. IA at 360 RPM we have determined, that is 120 amperes. EB at 360 RPM we have determined, that is 258 volts. Okay. Complete informing. Completed, very good. Now, actually in the problem they have asked you to determine the braking torque at 360 RPM. So braking torque at 360 RPM is full load torque into the armature current at 360 RPM by armature current at full load. Okay, so just now we have calculated armature current at 360 RPM. So full load torque, you already that has also been calculated. Okay, that is 363.6. Okay, into IA at 360 is 120, IA full load is 100. So 360, 66.6 into 120 by 100, you will get 764 Newton meter. Note it down and inform me. Completed. Okay, let us solve one more problem. So 30 kilowatt, 400 volts, three phase, four pole, 50 hertz induction motor has full load slip of 5%. Okay, so this problem is on induction motor. So to this induction motor, we are applying plug-in now to stop this motor. Okay, so a 30 kilowatt, 400 volts, three phase, four pole, 50 hertz induction motor has full load slip of 5%. If the ratio of the standstill reactance to resistance per motor phase is 4. Okay, standstill reactance to resistance value is given, that is reactance by resistance is equal to 4. Estimate the plugging torque at full speed. Okay, at full speed you have to determine the braking torque. Okay, so note down the question. As soon as you complete, type C. Completed. Okay, now let us initially determine the synchronous speed. This synchronous speed formula is well known to you, that is NS is equal to 120 f by p. Frequency is given, that is 50 hertz. Number of poles are given, that is 4. So NS is equal to 120 into 50 by 4, you will get 1500 rpm. So write it down. Completed. Okay, so you have calculated the synchronous speed. Now if you know the synchronous speed and if you know the slip value is not 55%. Okay, if you know the slip and if you know the synchronous speed, you can determine the full load speed. Okay, so full load speed is what? NS into 1 minus S. So NS is 1500, 1 minus S value is 5%, means 0.05. So 1500 into 1 minus 0.05, you will get 1425 rpm. Okay, you have got the full load speed. Now let us determine the full load torque. Full load torque is okay, full load torque is P by 2 pi into N by 60. So P is already given, that is supply voltage, that is 30 kilowatts. So 30 into 10 power 3 by 2 pi into And NFL, just now you have calculated full load speed, that is 1425, so 1425 by 60. So 30 into 10 power 3 by 2 pi into 1425 by 60, you will get 200 Newton meter. Full load torque is 200 Newton meter. And you people know the torque equation for the induction motor. Okay, so this equation is well known to you. Torque is proportional to S into R2 into E2 square, okay, by R2 square plus S square, X2 square. Okay, so I can rewrite it as E1 is equal to S1 into R2 into E2 square by R2 square plus S1 square into X2 square. I can rewrite that in this format. Okay. I can rewrite the torque equation as T1 proportional to S1 R2 E2 square by R1 square. I'm sorry, R2 square plus S1 square, X2 square. Similarly, I can once again write down one more torque equation as T2, okay, T2 proportional to S2 R2, okay, E2 square. I wanted to write 2 here, but it went somewhere else. Yeah. Okay, T2, this is T2. So I have an issue with my screen, I can't expand it. That's why I won't write on the screen. I can use a pen. If I'm able to expand the screen, I might have used a pen to write these equations, but it's not possible with the system that I have been using. So, see, I can, you know the torque relation with slip resistance and the induced EMF and reactance values. Okay, so this is a well-known formula to you. So you can rewrite this expression in terms of T1 and T2, torque 1 and torque 2 for two different slips, S1 and S2. So if you know T1, if you know T2, okay, you can take the ratio of these two torques, okay? You can take the ratio of these two torques, T2 by T1. Did you write it down? Did you complete? Make it fast. I have another class to handle, okay? After this class, I have another class. So if you, I have to complete this class. So T2 by T1 is what, whatever equations that you have got, numerator and denominator. So T2, S2, R2, E2 square by R2 square plus S2 square, X2 square by S1, R2, E2 square by R2 square plus S1 square, X2 square. Okay, you just rearrange the terms and you just, whichever term is cancelled, you just cancel it, okay? And you will get a reduced expression as S2 by S1 into 1 plus S1 square into X2 by R2 whole square by 1 plus S2 square into X2 by R2 whole square. Okay, so already in the problem, if you have carefully listened while I was telling you, the ratio of standstill reactance to resistance per motor phase is 4 is given. Okay, the ratio of standstill reactance to resistance is 4. So here, X2 by R2 is nothing but 4. So if you observe in the next expression, I have written, instead of X2 by R2, I have written 4. So T2 by T1 is equal to S2 by S1 into 1 plus S1 square into 4 by 1 plus S2 square into 4 square. Okay. So this is T2 by T1. Okay. So if I want the, the braking torque, that is the plugging torque, T2. T2 is equal to what? Okay. T2, if T1 is the um, Okay, T1 we have, I think we have already calculated, that is the full load torque. Okay, so I have assumed this T1 as the full load torque and T2 is the braking torque. So T2 is equal to S2 by S1 into 1 plus S1 square into 4 square by 1 plus S square into 4 square into T1. Okay, so same, I have just sent this T1. T1 is nothing but my, full load torque. Okay, so S2 is, I can determine the S2. I think you already know the formula to determine S2, 2 minus full load slip. Full load slip is 0.05. So 2 minus 0.05 is 1.95. S2 is 1.95. So 1.95. So 1.95 by S1 is 0.05. 1 plus, this is S1. S1 is 0.05. Whole square into X2 by X, R2 is 4 square. By 1 plus, this is S2, 1.95 whole square into X2 by R2 is 4. Whole square into T1, that is full load torque is 200. Okay, so braking torque is T2, T1 is the full load torque. So if you simplify this expression, you get 131 Newton meter. Okay, so write down T2 by T1, complete this slide as quickly as possible.